Hi, I'm Jim Cunneen, and what we've got here is a self-standing garden wall. What I'd like to do now is show you how to build one that is smaller and more of a countertop space, and also mobile. You can keep it around your grill. We've got our materials. Step one is the bottom of the wall. Measure this out to the distance we need. So I'm cutting it 57 inches. Measure twice, cut once. Next piece is going to be the two upright sides. They're going to be cut just a little more than 36 inches. Okay, those are our sides. We're going to taper from this end up to here. We're going to want this 6 inches wide here, down to 12 inches wide there. So there's our center line marked there. So we want to go 3 inches from that side in either direction. Now what we need is a straight edge to draw our line going across that. Okay, board's been marked. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna rip this. Now you got a doorstop. So what we wanna do is lay this over top of the other one and mark our next cut. So we're making basically a template. We've got the base cut, we've got the sides cut, now we're gonna attach the two together. Just line it up there as close as you can get. You wanna take a drill gun and pre-drill that. We're gonna move on to the other side. Our sides are connected. Next thing we wanna do is our support members that come across both ways to keep this from pressing out. So I'm gonna pre-drill on both sides. Those holes are through. I'm gonna run those through. I want them just to stick out, just barely from the inside. And that way, when you put the wood up to it, that little bit of nib that's hanging out there will hold it. Okay, that's that. So we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. We've got our distance across the bottom. We wanna cut two pieces of wood at 57 inches. If we're longer, it's gonna push this outward. If we're short, it's gonna bring it in. So we wanna stay right at 57 inches. Next step is just to set these in here. We've already got the screws poking through just a little bit to help us hold it in place. Okay, that's the first one. Now we're gonna put the second one up in there like we did before, just kind of line it up. We've got our cross members up. Now the next thing we wanna do is get our internal irrigation system set up for this. So basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drill a hole right here. It's gonna be an 1¼ inch paddle bit. Very common bit. I like to go through from this side just so it looks a little nicer. There we go. Nice hole ready for the irrigation to be set through. Basically, this is a soaker hose that can be bought from the Home Depot. We got way more than we need. And also, if you've noticed, that won't fit through the hole. Not a problem. What we're gonna do is just pull out enough and cut that off. And the rest of this we can use on another project. Put the irrigation hose through, leave a little bit hanging out just because, you know, you want the hose to be able to bend and move. What we're gonna do is we're gonna secure it with these cable clamps. So we're just gonna take one of these guys and we're just gonna drive that on in. And that just holds it in place. I'm gonna do this just to speed things up. Don't wanna do with this is have a hard crimp in that, because if you crimp that, it's not gonna get any water going through it. You want a nice slow bend. Now we gotta make sure as we close off the end. There's a little fitting that's made for this. You just put it over one side, bend the pipe over, and lay it over like that. That'll clamp it off. All right, next step is to drill the weep holes in the bottom so this thing can drain. We're gonna just lay this over, and I'm gonna take a 1/2 inch speed bit. Okay, there's our weep holes. Our next thing is gonna be building the lattice. We've already got the cross member across the top. Here's another piece that we're gonna stick in right across here like this. Basically, the infrastructure of this is all finished. So we have to flip this over on its side and get an idea of our spacing for the lattice. Okay, Here we got our filter cloth, weed mat, whatever you want to call it. What we're going to do is just stretch that out, bring it across, and then I'm going to nail it down with my staple gun. The tighter the better. It looks much nicer if it's good and tight. I'm going to be a little careful on this because this is a thin piece of wood right here. You don't want to lean too heavy on it, wind up breaking it and having to start over. You know, I think I'm going to keep this and just wrap that under and nail it again, just because this is kind of thin material and I don't want it to rip, and that way a little extra nailing wouldn't hurt on that. Here's our cloth that we need for this, basically the chicken wire. I'm gonna stretch it across, and it's gonna definitely give us a little more rigidity to the whole project. So what I wanna do here is tack one side down, then go over there and make sure that other side's down, because if this isn't right, we're gonna have all kinds of problems. What's going to be nice is that lattice screwed into this will really help hold this in place. That's on there pretty good, a little trimming, and we are off to the races with that one. Now we've got the one side finished. What I want to do before I button up the other side is make sure that we've got some of this filter material over the holes so we don't have a problem with any of the soil eroding through it. So we just had a little scrap piece, so I'm just going to throw it on there and tack her down. Okay. Now our next step is just do the same thing we did there on the other side, and then we can start laying out the lattice pieces. Now we've got our filter cloth in, we've got our hardware cloth tacked down on top of it, we've laid out our lattice work. So what I'm gonna do is come in, tack in the corners, and screw those down. And another little thing that we decided to use on this were these little grommets. The screw goes through it, and you drive this in, it flares out the pressure so you don't wind up splitting your board. There, look at that. Tight as all get out. We'll get our corners good, and then we can mess with the center as we go. That's got our corners tacked down, so what I'm gonna do is just readjust all these and go around and knock this out. This is gonna have several bags of soil in it, and it's gonna be very heavy, and you're gonna want a good quality wheel in order to maneuver this thing around. So we just wanna set them up basically right in the corners. Get them as far out as you can so this thing will have stability. Then basically just make marks where they need to be, because you're going to want to pre-drill those, because you don't want to fight putting in the lag bolts that hold them. We're using 1/4 inch by 1.5 inch lag bolts. So there we go with that. There's our holes marked. Get a little pilot hole going. Okay, there's our pilot holes. We'll take our first wheel, line it up over top of that. Good idea to throw a washer on it just to disperse some of the pressure. Now they're snugged down. We've got the wheels on that, and it's sitting right side up. What we're gonna do now is our last bit of carpentry, which is cut out the center oval that's gonna hold some of the plant material. So I took this, put it here, drew some circles around it, and I'm just gonna connect the dots. Okay, well, we've got it all marked. So now what I need to do is drill a pilot hole in here somewhere. Now the hole's drilled. This is the saw we're gonna use for this. And there you go. Well, looks like we've got this thing pretty well put together. The next step is to fill this with a high quality potting mix, like this Miracle-Gro product we have here. It looks like we're gonna wind up using somewhere between 6 to 7 bags to fill this up. Well, full of soil. We're back with the plant materials. This is gonna be our herb side. The other side could be ornamentals or whatever you wanna do, but we're gonna do herbs here. What I'm doing here is I'm cutting out a nice size hole that we can open up like that. What I'm gonna do also too is press this in, and that's gonna keep my soil away so I can get the roots down in there without it falling in. I'm thinking I wanna go with the rosemary at this point. Just wanna loosen it just a little bit. We can ease the plant into the hole that we've cut, and the nice thing about this is the flap will help hold the plant upward so it doesn't droop and fall down to you. So what I wanna do here is come down. I'm gonna start with that right about here. We've got 2 little bars right here. So I'm gonna cut from this way, because if you cut that open, this whole thing could fall right out on you. Use my little super tool I made. Push the soil up, loosen up our roots a little bit. Hold that before you pull that out. And all that soil falls right down on top of the roots you just put in. We've got a few more to do, of course, and we've got ornamentals to go on the other side. So once both sides are planted, we can put the top on and plant the ones in the very top. This is a big project, but boy, it was well worth it. We've got our irrigation hookup on the other side. We're gonna put the hose to it, let it run a half hour or so, soak it in. I'm Jim Cunneen, and let's get out and play in the dirt.